We've got lots of people who've submitted questions online.
All right, let's go.
Joseph says, if all the people who don't know Jesus as Savior are going to hell after they die, and those who do are going to heaven, then what's the point of the judgment seat?
Well, there's got to be some final determination. They're not, we're talking about the lake of fire. We're talking about serious forever. And the great white throne judgment will be for the acts of what people have done in the flesh, and that will be a judgment. They aren't, they're in a waiting situation. Hades is kind of like an interim place, and paradise is kind of an interim place. But this is final, and the great white throne. Everybody will stand before God to account for what he's done, except, and keep this in mind, except those who have come to Jesus. And he says, he that hears my word, believes on him that sent me, shall not come into judgment, but is passed from death into life. We're passed from death into life because of Jesus Christ, so we won't have to give account at the great white throne judgment for what we've done. Thank God. Mm-hmm. All right. But we will have to stand before the judgment seat of Christ. There'll be rewards.
Everyone will, right?
Well, no, Christians will. The judgment seat of Christ is Christians.
Oh.
and that's the rewards for, you know, service to him. All right.
This is Laura who says, I hate to say this, Pat, but Huff was better behaved than Princess Maggie.
Princess Maggie was terrified. She jumped into my lap for
yeah, that. I have to say, if I was Maggie looking at Huff coming toward me, I think I might have jumped into your lap, too.
She's only a four-month-old puppy, and this great beast, she thought he might eat her.
And she might be right. Who knows?
Yeah, well, she came running across and jumped into my lap like, Daddy, help me. All right, what?
This is Kim who says, is it wrong to pray to God when you need help to find a reasonably priced car? With all the problems in the world, I feel guilty asking God for something so trivial.
I remember hearing a missionary who prayed for a needle because her clothes were falling off. And she just asked, she'd been in prison for so long, and she just said, God, I just want a needle and thread. So there's nothing trivial. God's people, everything pertaining to God's people, he's concerned about. And so if you need a low-priced car, there's nothing wrong with asking him for that.
He's our father. I mean,
he's a father. He looks after you, but he's concerned about his children. All right, what else?
Hey, this is Rosman, who said, recently I prayed with you for pain in my knees, and praise God, my knees were healed. However, I woke up the next day, and the pain had returned. It's like the healing was nothing more than a wonderful dream. What happened to my healing, and how do I get it back?
Well, people can give it up. I mean, you know, you don't believe that it's real. And you say, well, it's a wonderful dream, but you didn't receive it. You've got to receive it, stand on it, take it, and praise God for it. This is mine. And you can ask it back. I mean, this may be satanic, and the things come back on you. They come back, and you need to rebuke it and command it to leave you permanently. All right?
This is Betty who says, I can't pray when I'm in public. I freeze up, and the words won't come. What am I doing wrong?
Betty, you're just self-conscious, and you're not doing anything wrong. That is, it's a part of self. You're concerned about you instead of God. If your prayers were to God.
I think that happens often to people, especially, I mean, Betty's probably not a new believer, but, you know, they worry about whether the words they say are right or not. There are no right words. There are only real words.
Terry, you're exactly right. And it's your spirit communing with a spirit of God. And deep calls unto deep. So, who cares what the words say? You can just say, Father, God, 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 over and over again.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
He genuine, hears your heart. You're not praying to the congregation. You're praying to God.
Exactly. This is Mary Ann who says, recently my husband told me he noticed that we were both Capricorns. I thought astrology was bogus.
I was over in Pakistan, we were getting on an airplane. We were waiting in the, you know, where you stand waiting to go on an airplane. And a fellow came up to one of my security guys, and he said, I'm a Sagittarius. He said, what are you? And my security guy said, I'm a Mexican. No, we're not supposed to be under those signs, zodiacs. All right.
Okay, this is Sonia who says, there are churches where people fall on the floor after being touched by their preacher. Is this just something those church members do to put on a dramatic show, or is it real?
Well, there's some very real things. I mean, the power of God. You know, the guards came for Jesus, and he said, I am he, and they fell back. Under power, people get weak. They under the power of an angel and the power of the anointing of God. So in this case, but there are a lot of people who just professionally fall down. They just figure they're supposed to get fall down and fall down. Mm-hmm. But I was praying for somebody down in Texas. We had a station down there, and this woman wanted prayer, and she had a neck brace on, and I was holding my hand up like this, and God said to me, "Don't touch her." You know, I said, okay. So I'm praying for her. Well, our friend Henry Harrison was there, and he didn't hear from God. And so he reached out and touched her, and bang, she was down and hit her head and ooh, what have you. She got healed in her neck, but the Lord said, don't touch her, because she would have fallen over. And, you know, they have these people who do the catching, but this is real. They aren't fakes, but they're fakes and everything, but these people are sincerely under the anointing of the Holy Spirit, and that's good. Mm-hmm.